I mean, you still want to, right?
Are you kidding me? This is gonna kill them.
It's gonna wreck them. Can you see their faces when we come back, Mary?
Oh, I'm picturing it right now.
Me too. What do you think they're doing right now?
What time is it?
I don't know if it's 10 o'clock here. It's 1 o'clock there. Probably having lunch.
Ooh. He's making her cut the edges off his sandwich. I bet she never expected that. Real men eat the crust.
And she's serving that tuna salad she always makes. Ooh. Oh, and he's pretending to like it, like I did for all those years.
Well, it serves them right.
If they only knew what we were about to do.
It would devastate them.
It would destroy them.
I hate them for what they did to you.
I hate them for what they did to you. Sorry. We're here to do the deed, tie the knot. You know, get hitched. Walk down the aisle, put on the old ball and chain.
We're here to get married. I don't think she speaks English. Oh, you want to get married?
Yes. Please?
Well, we can do that. We're a wedding chapel.
I know that. That's why we're here.
Well, good. Then we're all on the same page, yes?
Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
So you do it right here?
There's the altar. You're just 10 steps away from wedded bliss and a lifetime of martial law. I mean marital joy.
I'm sorry, are you being sarcastic? Don't you think she's being sarcastic?
Maybe it's a Vegas thing.
Yeah, maybe. So, what do we need to do?
Well, why don't you have a seat and we'll go through your options. We have lots of wedding ceremonies for you to choose from. Are you looking for a traditional wedding or something themed?
Traditional.
Okay. Our packages start at $200 and go into the thousands. Maybe we should start there. How much did you want to spend?
$2,000? You really want to spend that much?
Well, it is our wedding.
It is your wedding.
Yes, of course, but we already spent a lot just getting here. What do we get for $200?
A rose, a boutonniere, an 8x10. Don't blink! Oh, you closed your eyes.
That's all we really need, right?
I don't know. We're here. What kind of themed weddings do you do? I always thought it'd be fun to be married by Elvis.
Really?
We do Elvis. We do Blues Brothers. We do Wayne Newton. I think our Cher is on maternity leave, but I could get you a Donna Summer if you want to do the whole disco thing. MacArthur Park is melting in the dark.
No. We do not want Donna Summer.
Okay, we do fairy tale weddings. We do Victorian weddings. We do gangster weddings. We do Star Trek weddings in Klingon, if you like. That's, I now pronounce you husband and wife. We will marry you on horseback, on Harleys, in a helicopter over the Grand Canyon.
Over the Grand Canyon? I always wanted to see the Grand Canyon. Did you hear that, Stan? The Grand Canyon!
There is the Lady of the Lake ceremony where you can get married on a 60-foot private yacht.
Could we get Elvis on the yacht too?
Sure. He's willing to pay for it. Now, do you want the fat Elvis or the thin Elvis?
Oh, the thin. The thin.
Okay, so under the thin Elvis, we have the Army Elvis, the Hawaiian Elvis, the 1968 comeback Elvis.
Ooh, the Hawaiian Elvis. I always loved him. Will he sing?
Will he sing? Whatever your little heart desires. Okay, so Hawaiian Elvis. The Hawaiian Elvis includes a full band, 3 backup singers in grass skirts, a luau pig roast, Polynesian dancers, tiki torches, fire eaters, hula lessons, flamethrowers.
Whoa, ladies. This is getting way out of control. Fire eaters, flamethrowers, fat Elvises.
Oh no, honey, we want the band.
We don't want either. We just want to get married right now, right here, without all this ridiculousness.
Are you calling my wedding dreams ridiculous?
These aren't your dreams. She just put these into your head. We never talked about anything like this. The plan was to come here and get married, and then go home and throw it in Ed and Jenny's faces and watch them fall apart, remember? That was the dream.
Oh, yeah.
Remember what they did to us? Remember our humiliation? How they deceived us and divorced us?
Yeah.
How they made us look like fools?
Yeah. This isn't a wedding. This is payback. We'll just do the basic wedding then.
All right, that's one traditional ceremony for the happy couple.
Okay, that was sarcastic. I'm not liking your attitude.
Please, let's just do this, okay? So when can we get married?
All right, well, let's see. Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
I thought in Las Vegas you just walked in and did it.
I'm just kidding. There's no waiting. There's just one thing. My minister stepped out for just a moment.
Well, when's he coming back?
How long does it take to get schnockered? Just kidding! He'll be back in just a minute. So, that's one traditional ceremony. That's a rose, a boutonniere, an 8x10. You know, for another $20, you can have a video of the ceremony so that you'll always remember this sacred day. Or, even better, for another $50, you can broadcast it live over the internet for family and friends who couldn't attend. Maybe you would like to invite Ed and Jenny to watch a joyous ceremony.
Really? We can do that?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think, Bev?
I think I better put on some lipstick. Is there somewhere?
Sure, there's a dressing room in the back. Help yourself.
We're getting married live!
So, you must be excited. This is your wedding day.
I'll cut the crap, lady.
Gladly. Thank you. It's exhausting.
Then why do you do it?
People expect it.
Would it be too much to expect a little sincerity, too?
Oh, give me a break, Stan. I've been doing this for 17 years. Can you imagine 17 years of watching people make the biggest mistakes of their lives, all with a big smile on my face?
You are seriously jaded.
12 hours from now, I'm gonna have them lined up outside that door. Half of them drunk, all of them in love, whatever that means. And I'm going to have to put on my happy face and walk them down the aisle of eternal wedded bliss.
If you hate it so much, then why do you do it?
I'm a sucker for romance.
Ha! Ever been married?
4 times. 5th time's gonna be the charm, though. I can feel it. You strike me as a real romantic, too.
Yeah, right.
Seriously, underneath all that anger beats the heart of a man in love.
I'm not angry.
Yeah, and I'm not flaky.
I was only married once.
To Jenny?
Yeah.
You got kids?
2 boys. They live with them. I see them every other weekend.
I assume she and Ed are married now.
No, they're getting married next Saturday.
Aha!
What does that mean?
It's an expression that denotes a sudden revelation.
I know what aha means, lady. What's the revelation?
Jenny and Ed are getting married. So, you're going to get married first to show them that you don't care that they're getting married. But the very fact that you flew thousands of miles to prove to them that you don't care that they're getting married says very loudly how much you do.
You talk to all your customers this way?
Just the ones I think I can save.
How do we set up this internet?
I give you an address, you give it to them, and they watch.
Where's the camera?
Right there.
All right, let's do this. I'm calling Jenny.
You seem to know that number pretty well.
Used to be mine. Jenny, I thought there's something you might be interested in watching on the internet. If you get this message, go to, what's the address?
www.littlechapel.com.
www.littlechapel.com.
/wedding broadcast/Stan and Bev. /2020-July. /2020-July.
Okay. Goodbye. Oh, this is Stan. Stan Dreyer.
Okay, so this is good. You'll get married, they'll watch, and boy, won't they be sorry, right?
Right.
Look what I found. There's a whole rack of them back there, some with big hoops and parasols and puffy sleeves and slinky backs. I was going crazy trying to pick one out. There's a bunch of tuxedos back there, too.
I see you found our rental area.
Well, I figure as long as we're going to do this and as long as they're watching, we might as well do it upright. Look our best. What do you think?
Yeah, definitely. Good idea.
Go get yourself a tux.
We're going to look so good. They're going to eat their hearts out.
They're going to be sick.
Well, don't you look lovely?
Stoic, crazy lady.
Gladly.
Longer I can keep this up.
Keep what up?
This. All this venom, this bile. It's grueling.
Are you saying you're not angry?
I'm not angry.
You don't hate Jenny and Ed?
Don't hate Jenny and Ed.
You don't want to crush them or destroy them or otherwise cause them irreparable physical and emotional harm?
No. I wish them the best. I really do.
Well, run me over with the rented limousine. I did not see that coming.
I do some acting back home. Community theater. They say I was the best Blanche Dubois ever.
Well, you're certainly putting on quite a show today.
I know, but how do I stop? When we first found out, Stan and I were so crushed. Then we were angry. And the anger seemed to bring us together. And then at some point I stopped being angry and started falling for Stan. Now I just want to marry him so we can be together all the time. I'm in love.
Yeah, but he's in hate.
I know. What should I do?
I'd start by calling off the wedding.
No, I can't do that. I'm in love. I love him. I love his scrawny arms. I love his big feet. I love his messy hair. I love his 70s wardrobe.
Are you sure you don't want to set your sights just a little higher?
Once we're married, everything will work out fine, I'm sure of it. You'll forget all about Jenny and fall in love with me.
You know what I've learned after one husband, four marriages, and 17 years in this business? Any sentence that starts with "once we're married" is a train bound for heartbreak. If it ain't great now, it ain't gonna get great, and no amount of wishing is gonna make it so.
You're right. You're absolutely right.
So what are you gonna do?
Oh, marry the man I love.
Do I look handsome? Or what?
You look wonderful.
I sure hope Jen's watching. All right, let's get this show on the road. Is your minister back? Well, where is he? What's he doing?
That's a good question.
Hey, Sandy. Ken out in the parking lot. He's sick, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Put him in the back seat of his car. He's sleeping it off.
Thanks. Again.
Are you saying you have no minister?
Got a few minutes?
Sure.
Great, because this lovely couple here really wants to get married, and for all the right reasons. So I'll just go and get your flowers, and I'll be right back.
I hope you don't mind getting married by Elvis. We got a wedding clock at 11 o'clock, and they requested bouquet.
It doesn't matter to us. We just want to get this thing over with.
Stan, we love Elvis. Yeah. This is perfect.
Good. It's Some people feel like it trivializes things. But you know what I always say is, you're in love and you're sincere, what does it matter who marries you, right?
Right. So do you enjoy marrying people?
Yeah, it's a great gig, but...
But what?
Well, after marrying all these other people, I kind of feel like, you know, it's my turn, like, to find a wonderful woman and fall in love.
Uh-huh.
Love me, tender love, me soon. Never let me go.
That was beautiful. The song and the wish. I can't believe you don't meet a lot of girls in this town.
I meet a lot of girls, just not the right ones. Hell, half the time I'm not even sure they're women. There's a lot of trannies in this town.
Ooh, that's a transvestite, Stan.
I know what a tranny is.
I don't think we have any of those in Virginia. We're from Roanoke.
Oh, nice. And you came here just to get married?
Yes. Marrying the man I love.
Well, congratulations. You are a lucky man. She seems like a wonderful woman.
Okay, here we go. Flowers for the blushing bride and a boutonniere for the grimacing groom.
Ow!
Now, all we need is a witness, and we can enter you into the bonds of sweet, blissful matrimony.
We don't have a witness. No one said anything about a witness.
You don't have a witness? What are we gonna do? I'm just kidding. I'll be your witness.
Fine, whatever. Are we still alive?
Yes, we are. Take it away, Elvis.
Live from Las Vegas, it's showtime. Today, we're going to celebrate the special wedding of these two very special kids,
Stan and Bev.
Stan and Bev! Now, Stan, bring that little lady over here so we can celebrate your special day and your special union. Elvis style. All right. Now, Stan and Bev, you're here today because you guys are shook up in love with one another. Now, I know you both been through a heartbreak hotel, oh baby. Well, we all have. But today, and every other day, you're gonna love each other tender and love each other sweet. Now, I want the two of you to turn to each other. I want you to look each other in the eyes and hold hands. Now, Beth. Do you take Stan here to be your husband? Will you love and comfort him and honor and keep him and all forsaking all others? Be his hunka-hunka burning love?
I will.
All right. Now, Stan, do you take Bev to be your wife? Will you love and comfort her and honor and keep her and forsaking all others? Be her hunka-hunka burning love?
I'm sorry.
That, are you?
It might be important.
We're getting married, Stan.
I got a grief, little lady. You answer that? You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Hello?
You're scratching all the time.
Sorry, I can't
get you. You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
And you ain't no friend of mine.
Well, who is it? What do they want?
It's Jenny. She's watching. She says don't do it.
What?
She says don't do it. Don't get married.
How dare she? She ruins our lives once and that's not enough. She's gotta do it again. Once wasn't enough, Jenny? You gotta try and spoil my happiness a second time? Well, bring it on, bitch. Bring it on. Is she still on there? Give me the phone.
No,
give it
no,
to
no,
me.
No,
give
no.
It
little love runs a mighty crooked course.
It's Beverly. What the hell do you think you're doing? What? You what? This is insane. I'm losing my mind. Elvis, I think I might faint.
You all right?
Yes.
Good. It's me again. You really? What about him? When? Are you saying you want me back?
Stan, hang up the phone right now. Elvis, pick up where you left off. I think we're uncovering the burning love. Stan, stand next to me. Come on, Elvis, it's now or never.
It's now or never. Come on. thing, darling.
No, I want you to hurry up.
Stop, Beth. Just stop. It's no use. I'm still in love with Jenny, and it seems she still loves me, too.
No, no. If you just hang up the phone, everything will be okay. Once we're married, everything will work out fine.
I tried to tell her where that train goes.
I'm sorry. I don't love you. I love Jen. I've always loved Jen. I'm coming home, baby. I'm taking the first plane. I love you, I love you, I love
hey.
You!
Don't be cruel, man.
I'm sorry, but we were just getting even. It's not like we were in love or anything, right? Right?
Right.
Right. Tell the boys Daddy's coming home.
Viva Las Vegas!
Somebody new.
How long will that take?
You feeling bad, Carl? I don't know. But you meet new people all the time. Hi. I'm John.
I'm Beth. Oh, dear.
Maybe I can use you until I find a permanent minister.
Was he too old?
Too unreliable. Didn't stop me from marrying him, though. 4 times, God help me.
You married him 4 times? That means you divorced him 3.
You're good at math.
So where is he?
Look, we've got a celebrity coming in. 2 celebrities, actually. Their press agent made it very clear they want everything perfect. These things are always more trouble than they're worth.
Oh, they sure are.
Have you done many celebrity weddings?
Oh, yeah. Over the years, dozens. And big stars, too. Paul and Joanne. Steve and Edie. Bert and Angie. Zsa Zsa and, well, I forget, but I married her several times.
And recently?
Well, I don't recall so much. You know, today's stars aren't like the old stars. They're just not as big.
God, hello! Let it through, let it through. I love it. I'll be like her too!
Watch the code, watch the code.
Sorry, no time for autographs. Let it through.
Yes, we love you too. Thank you for letting us through. Thank you.
We have arrived.
You may take our things.
Here, let me get those from you. I'll just put them right over here. You are...
Vanessa Wells.
And Bryce Cannon.
Yes, of course. What an honor to have you with us today. I hope you found the chapel without too much trouble.
We were practically mobbed outside.
Nearly tore this jacket right off me.
I don't see anybody out there.
Well, they were there. Mobs of them.
Throngs.
Whores, and who could blame them? 2 of Hollywood's biggest stars getting married. A dream wedding of momentous proportions.
2 luminaries of unspeakable achievement in stage.
Screen.
And philanthropy.
2 of the world's most beautiful people.
If we may say so without conceit.
Now, uniting our empires, our lives, and the holy bonds of matrimony.
What an occasion for the world to celebrate.
Yes, it most certainly is quite the occasion.
So, you 2 are actors, huh?
Who is this little man?
This is Lewin. He's a real kidder. He knows who you are. Would you sit down and be quiet?
So have you been in any pictures I would know?
We do not make pictures.
We make films.
We make art.
We make movies, if you must. But we do not make
pictures.
Oh, okay. Have you been in any movies I would know?
Well, there was that one little movie I did. It won 8 Academy Awards, called The Cold, Cold River. I played a minor but pivotal role. Perhaps you heard of that?
He was brilliant. Well, brilliant.
I don't think so.
No, surely you recall my portrayal of Mother Teresa in the independent film, The Saint of Calcutta. I gave a performance that many have called utterly inspiring.
Oh, yes.
It's not ringing a bell.
And of course you were glorious as the head servant in that BBC production of Mary, Queen of Scots.
As were you in the Budapest remake of Gone with the Wind, where you played a riveting Hungarian Ashley Wells.
Oh, thank you, my pet, thank you.
I'm sorry.
Well, we actually did do a television series together many years ago when we were much younger.
Oh.
It was hugely successful. I'm sure even you would remember it. We played a pair of newlywed spies who did a majority of our espionage while on surfboards.
The Surfing Secret Agents!
Now I remember you. That show was huge. Yeah, of course. Wow, you gotten old.
It was 30 years ago. Of course we've gotten older, but we haven't aged. Oh, no.
No, we've matured.
We've blossomed.
We've perfected our bodies and our minds.
Pursued careers of great critical acclaim.
Perfecting our crafts, rejecting the common commercial scripts they offered us, and choosing instead films of substance and matter.
You couldn't get jobs after the show, huh?
Who is this little man and must he be here?
Quiet. Lou's one of the most experienced ministers in all of Vegas. He's married all the biggest stars. Only the best for you. So, why don't we sit down and get started with your wedding? Will anyone else be joining us?
Where are the reporters? There are supposed to be reporters. What is a wedding without reporters?
I'm sorry, was I supposed to arrange for
that? I thought your agent was handling that.
No, my agent is in the Caribbean finalizing my latest divorce. Your agent was supposed to handle it.
Well, I'm sure he did then.
Call him.
Your outfit is just lovely.
Of course it is.
Hey, Monty. Yes, it's Bryce. Now, we're here at the church. Where are the reporters? No, not a one. Or did you tell them 11 o'clock? Why would you tell them the right place, Monty? Well, no one is here, Monty. No one, and she is pissed.
Monty, you idiot. How did you manage to screw this up, huh? We are standing here, both of us looking fabulous for the cameras. And you know what? No cameras, no reporters, just some strange little men ogling and harassing me. This is not the grand publicity event we discussed, Monty. And you know why? Because a publicity event requires publicity! No, you get on the phone and get me some reporters. People, us, Entertainment Weekly,
Star.
The Star, National Enquirer. I want them all down here to record and celebrate our wedding union!
So, how long you kids been in love?
I need a drink. What have you got?
I've got some champagne in the back. Get it.
Are you sure about that, Pat? I mean, you're just out of the tank. You're barely dry.
Get it? How else am I going to get through this day?
I'll be right back.
I had an uncle that was a lush. He drowned while taking a shower. And when they found him the next day, he was still standing up. Dead, but standing.
Who chose this chapel, your agent or mine?
Can you believe that?
Whichever one it is, he's fired. Call Monty again and find out how he's doing.
We just hung up.
You can't tell me the world isn't interested in this story. For God's sake, prove it, that's a Wells!
And Bryce Cannon!
30 years ago, they would have killed for this story. They would have given anything to see us get together in real life.
I'm back. Did I miss anything?
Oh.
We were America's sweethearts with our skimpy wetsuits and our perfect bodies and our windswept hair that never seemed to get wet, even as we surfed 20-foot waves while chasing Russian spies and other traitors to the nation. The world couldn't get enough of us.
Agent 76.
And Agent 44.
We'd find our fans hiding in our dressing room closets.
In the trunks of our cars.
Under tables in restaurants.
Behind bushes.
Under piles of leaves.
We were on the cover of every magazine for years. All the interviews, the press events, the action figures. I can still hear the crowds calling out to us. Vanessa, Bryce, can I get an autograph, please? That idiot show made us the biggest stars in the world.
And the mail. The mail we used to get. You know, they had to hire a whole staff at the studio just to handle our mail.
I believe it.
Lose something, little man?
I was just looking for the restroom.
Oh, it's in the back.
I thought you worked here. I knew it. I knew there was no way this little man was a professional minister.
No, he is. He really is. My regular minister just wasn't available today, so I had to hire Lou. That's all.
Not available? For the biggest wedding this town has seen in decades? Vanessa Wells!
And Bryce Cannon!
Well, it's a long story. You're not really interested in my problems anyway.
Oh, contraire, I would love to hear about your problems. I'm so tired thinking about my... Go ahead, please. Tell all chapel proprietor. Still.
Vanessa! What are you thinking? Wrinkles!
Oh!
No!
Oh.
No, dear, not your face, your dress!
Oh.
Isn't that linen?
My, thank you, Bryce. Oh. A momentary lapse. I'll just take it off until the press arrives.
You know? I think I'll do the same. We learned this on set. Never sit in your costume. Not if you want to look your best, which is, of course, all that matters.
Little man, put your eyes back in your head. I thought you had to go to the bathroom.
I could wait.
Hang this, please, and continue with your story.
Yes, amuse us, please, with your tale. Whoa.
Well, this isn't getting weird at all, is it? Okay, the story of Sandy and Ken. I'll give you the abridged version. Sandy and Ken fall in love. Ken continues falling in love with various other women throughout their marriages. I say marriages because Sandy would get fed up, divorce Ken, change her mind, take him back, and after many promises, marry him again. And again, and again. Did I also mention that Ken drinks too much? This is the part that affects Sandy's business. During one of their longer breaks, Sandy opens a wedding chapel. Ken tracks her down as usual, promises her the moon as usual, and even goes so far as to become an ordained minister to try and wheedle his way back into her life.
Does it work?
Yes, it works. Otherwise, we'd have no story, would we? And now, not only does Ken wreak havoc on Sandy's emotional life, but on her professional life as well, since he frequently shows up intoxicated for work, if at all, which is why you're here, and why I'm such an idiot.
Women, we're all such idiots. Why do we let men manipulate us and ruin our lives?
Because we love them?
Because we hate ourselves.
We do?
We must. Otherwise, why would we stand for such callous behavior? Why would we put up with the rogues and the cats and the scoundrels?
Because we're weak?
Because we are strong.
I'm not very good at this, am I?
Only a strong woman can endure a man who lies and cheats and loses her entire fortune at the blackjack table and yet forges ahead to a better life.
Oh, Ken's not a gambler.
I'm not talking about your life. Do you know how much money we made doing that idiot show? Do you know how long it took my first husband to lose it all at the Sands?
And yet, you survived.
Yes, I survived and went on to marry the Baron, a wonderful man who unfortunately enjoyed wearing ladies' lingerie. And then there was the senator who only wanted me for my fame and connections, and the record producer who only married me for my money. Was he surprised?
And then for some inconceivable reason, there was the plumber.
The plumber. Who at this very moment is in a Caribbean courtroom trying to take what little money I have left.
Oh, honey, what were you thinking?
I don't know, Bryce, I don't know.
And yet, you survived.
Yes, I did, as did you.
Yes, I made a few bad decisions along the way, made some bad investments, trusted the wrong people.
His own brother.
And found myself, like Vanessa, deprived of all of my secret agent earnings. At one point, I'll admit this to you and you only, I was living in a trailer. Now, afraid to come out and show my face to the other trailer park residents for fear of being recognized and pitied.
I didn't realize it had gotten so bad.
Oh, yes.
You should have called me Pet.
Oh, I did. You were in the tank.
Oh, I'm sorry. Which time?
Oh, it's hard to say.
Well, that's a crying shame, that is. Both of you. Losing everything you worked for.
But we went on, little man, we went on.
Yeah, we used our talents.
And our beauty.
To claw our way back.
But beauty is such a double-edged sword. You both can count yourselves lucky you haven't been cursed with it. Bryce, tell them how difficult it is to be beautiful.
Oh, the assumptions that you must be dim. The lecherous advances from those in power. The expectation of fans that you will never age, and their disappointment when they realize that, alas, You have?
How can we possibly look as good today as we did 30 years ago? It's physically impossible.
And yet, somehow, I do.
Come again.
Look at me, I'm flawless. Hardly an extra pound anywhere. Some crow's feet around the eyes, but hardly noticeable. Some graying around the sides, but that's considered sexy in men. All in all, I am fabulous.
And I'm not.
Of course, dear, just not as fabulous as I am. It's different for women. Things fall.
Oh, how dare you!
Well, it's just the inescapable truth, man. In the aging department, men fare much better. Sorry about that. Hey, am I right, brother?
I don't know if it's true or not, but this is no way to talk to the woman you love.
Love? The only person he loves or has ever loved is himself.
Oh, says the woman with a 5-foot picture of herself in her living room.
Says the man who tattooed his own name on his chest.
I told you that in confidence.
Don't take me on, Bryce. I know way too much. San Francisco raped me, too.
Ooh, and I don't know things, huh? Huh? Monte Carlo, 1999. Well, we both have our pasts.
But we don't care about the past anymore. It's the future we're looking towards, right?
Right.
We just need to get our names out there again.
Remind America how much they loved us.
Bring back the old magic. Yeah. I know we can do it, Bryce. Where are the reporters? Call an agent of yours right now. Find out what's happening.
Left in my pants. Monty, it's Bryce. Yeah, how's it going? Well, did you try to... Sure, but did you call the... Okay. Well, that's where we stand. Okay. Thanks.
Well?
No one is coming.
No one's coming?
No, they have no interest in the story.
But why? Why aren't they interested?
I don't know.
Well, call him back. I want to know why they're not interested. This makes no sense. We have a bona fide news story here, and I won't be satisfied until I know why. Call.
Monty, it's Bryce. Vanessa says she wants...
Why aren't they interested, Monty? You said they would be interested. You said this would be our big comeback. You said that this would catapult us back into the news. How could they not be? What? I see. And that's the reason why? Okay, I see.
Well?
You were right, they're not interested.
Yes, but did he tell you why?
Yes, he did. It seems they already know that you're gay. You haven't hidden it as well as you thought. And if you're gay, then why would we be getting married unless it's just a publicity stunt? And if it's just a publicity stunt, then they're not interested. Especially one involving a couple of washed up old celebrities. And take a quote.
We are not old. Everybody knows I'm gay.
Well, I kind of suspected, just because you're so pretty.
Well, I had no idea. You're so tall.
Well, I guess that's that.
Everyone knows.
Apparently so.
Well, it's a relief. Good. No, I'm glad. It's not like it's gonna hurt my career or anything, right?
Not really. Your career couldn't get much worse.
Nor could yours, my pet. Nor could yours.
Well, I have done numerous independent
student films. Let's be honest, it's just us.
All right, student films, but at least mine have been in English.
Well, at least mine have been pivotal roles, not maids and servants.
Pivotal roles? Do you know who he played in his Academy Award-winning film? The corpse on the examining table.
You know, enough! All right, why are we attacking each other? Huh? It's that stupid show that did this.
That idiot show.
Do you know what happens? You know what happens when you play a surfing secret agent for 5 years? And nobody takes you seriously anymore.
Nobody hires you because you become a joke.
A fool.
A clown. The reporter's right. We're washed up. Yesterday's news. Complete and total
has-beens.
Oh, come on, kids. It's not that bad. We've all had our low moments. But we come back. We survive. You said so yourself. Well, look at me. My precious wife of 40 years died a year ago. I couldn't have been any lower. But finally, I got myself out of the house. I said, I'm going back to work. But who would give an old guy like me a chance? Well, this nice little lady right here. So even when you think you're washed up, opportunity knocks.
That's right. You never know what's waiting for you just around the corner.
They don't understand.
No. How could they?
Chapel proprietor, little man, we appreciate this story, but we're talking about fame here. Fame of the highest order. We had it once. We will have it again.
Yes. Yes, we will.
The only question is, how are we going to get it? We need a new plan, a new plot.
What if...
Yes.
What if we announce that one of us is dying?
Yeah.
Something tragic, incurable. And I can see the headline in the Star now. Vanessa Wells, stricken, faithful friend at her bedside.
Why do I have to be the one that's dying?
Look at me.
All right. But what happens when months pass and I don't die?
Well, you got better.
I thought it was incurable.
Yeah, they were wrong. And then we have another story. Vanessa Wells, miracle recovery, faithful friend at her side.
And you're the faithful friend?
Of course.
I don't know. Maybe. Well, how about this? What if we announce that you're gay?
Thought everybody already knew.
Yes, but we officially announce it, and you give your first-hand account of the pain and shame of hiding your secret. Bryce Cannon, gay admission, faithful friend at his side.
I don't know if it's a big enough story. I mean, not today, anyway. Ooh! What if we announce you're gay, too? Both of the Serpent secret agents, gay and gay.
Now, who's going to believe that I'm a lesbian?
Well, you were really athletic on that show. I mean, you could really handle those waves.
Those were stunt doubles? For God's sakes.
Vanessa Wells gay? Wow, I'm speechless. And she's been married all those times.
I'm not gay, you ridiculous little man.
Well, you don't have to be ashamed about it. Be proud of who you are. I'm just very surprised. I guess the wedding's really off now.
See, we would have no trouble selling this story.
No, I won't do it. I won't be gay. We'll just have to think of something else.
Well, there's always the other
thing. Oh, God, not yet.
No, I think we're at the point now where maybe we have to consider.
Consider what?
The Surfing Secret Agents reunion special, 30 years later.
Nothing says you're washed up like a reunion special.
Yes, but there's interest in the project. They've been calling our agents.
But it would mean going back to that idiot show that ruined our lives.
It would also mean going back to TV in front of the cameras once again. I mean, imagine it. Miss Wells, take your place on set, please. Miss Wells, come to makeup, please. Miss Wells, it's time for your costume fitting. Miss Wells, would you sign some more autographs, please?
Yes, well, that all sounds very nice.
Who knows what producers might be watching? They'll see how fabulous we still look and how wonderfully we still work together.
Yes, yes.
It could be the beginning of big things for us. Come on, Van. Let's do it.
All right, yeah. Tell him we're in. Tell him to call the press.
Oh, this time tomorrow, baby, we could be back.
Oh my goodness, there's so much to be done. We must be on our way. Little man,
Go inside and clear away a path so that we can pass.
Huh?
You heard what she said. Go clear away the van.
But there's nobody
just
out there.
Go.
Clear the way. The stars are coming out.
Miss Wells, Mr. Cannon, I am sorry that today didn't work out, but I wish you the best in the future.
Oh, what a future it will be. You'll be hearing all about us very soon.
That's right. Look out, America. We are coming back.
Vanessa Wells.
And Bryce Cannon. All right, back up.
No, please let us through.
I'm telling you, there was nobody out there. What a pair, huh?
Yeah. Listen, Lou, I just don't think this is gonna work out.
Really?
You're a nice man, but I just don't think this is the right business for you anymore.
But I gotta do something or I'll go crazy. I gotta get out of the house.
Have you thought about volunteering your time?
Doing what?
What about a nursing home? You could perform for the residents as Elvis. And they're a captive crowd.
You know, it would be nice to do the old act again, and when I got my costume and my sideburns on, you can barely tell us apart, me and Elvis.
Is that right?
Yeah. Maybe sometime when I'm performing, you'll come and see my show. And I'll take you out for dinner afterwards.
Are you asking me out?
Well, not right now, but next time you divorce your husband, you give me a call.
Okay, Lou, I'll be sure to do that.
It was nice meeting you, Sandy.
Nice meeting you too, Lou. Good luck out there. Crazy little man.
Space. And unless you filed a written order to that effect, your mail carrier has committed a gross violation of the postal code.
Oh my.
Yes, it's best not to let this kind of conduct go. I would recommend that you speak to your mail carrier about the matter, and if you are not satisfied, talk to your local postmaster.
Well, aren't you official? Thank you. Was there anything else?
I'm Marvin Marvel. I'm getting married today. It should be on your schedule for 5 o'clock.
Marvin Marvel?
Yes.
Dear God, the kids must have had fun with you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Marvin Marvel. I'm not seeing anything.
I'm sure it's there. Look again, please.
I have a reservation for a Martin Marvel.
Well, that's me, of course. It's probably just a typographical error. Martin Marvin, it happens all the time.
People call you Martin all the time?
No. Typographical errors, they happen all the time. It's one of the leading reasons that mail doesn't get delivered to its intended destination, despite the best efforts of the U.S. Postal Service. You should see some of the misspelled envelopes we get. Some of the best laughs I've ever had, let me tell you. My golly.
So, Marvin, is there a bride somewhere?
Oh, yes, ma'am. She's just fixing her makeup in the car.
Oh, good. I'm just guessing here, and I've gotten pretty good at this over the years. I'd say you're from Salt Lake City, but you're not necessarily Mormon. Your bride is an elementary school teacher, and you've been sweethearts all your lives. Now, why are you getting married in Vegas? That's always the toughest part. Seems to me you'd be getting married in a church surrounded by family and friends in the local postal squad.
My family and friends don't approve of the wedding.
Now, don't help me, I can do this.
And they don't approve of Fiona.
Fiona! How could they not approve of Fiona, sweet, innocent, child-loving, Midwestern Fiona?
Oh, yeah? Why don't you come on and say that to my face, you piece of peep-and-tongue shit? My fiance will jack you up like you ain't never been jacked, you punk-ass mother, ever!
Okay, I was a little off.
Someone bothering you, Angel?
Just some punk-ass watch me change my clothes in the car? Oh, yeah, you better run, you yellow freaking blizzard shit!
Hey, baby, we all set to get married?
Yeah, I think so. You like the place?
Oh, Marvin, it's like a dream. I never thought I'd be getting married in a place so fancy with a real altar and, oh my God, real flowers. I wish Fisk could see this. He wanted to marry me in a toilet stall. I'm so lucky I found you, Marvin.
Oh, we lucky we found each other. How come you took out the wedding dress, Angel? It looked so nice on her.
It just wasn't me, baby. All that lace was itching me, and that white was a nightmare. Like I'd been sentenced to 100 years of church or something, you know?
Yeah.
I'm trying to change for you, baby. I really am. Hey, did you see back there when I said, mother effer, I stopped myself before saying the whole word?
Oh, I sure did. And I'm proud of you.
It's just that I'm afraid I can't change too much at a time, or else I'm afraid my atoms will get too confused. And when your atoms get too confused, there's no telling what might happen. I read all about it in Ladies' Home Journal. People with confused atoms sometimes turn into hermaphrodites. You know what that is? It's like a half man, half woman kind of thing.
Oh, Angel, I don't think that can happen.
Well, just in case, I'm gonna take it slow, okay?
Okay.
I mean, you still like me like this, right?
I love you like this.
You two are fascinating! And I haven't been fascinated by anything that's happened around here in a long time. I mean, we're talking 17 years of weddings that have included psychopaths and circus freaks and celebrities, even a pair of conjoined twins marrying another pair of conjoined twins, and none of them have fascinated me the way you two have. Bravo!
What's with this bitch? She disrespecting us?
No disrespect.
Calling us circus freaks?
No.
I'll freak you up.
No, you misunderstand.
I'm gonna take you out back, show you a little something I learned in the big house. Give you a little state issued overhaul, if you know what I'm saying.
And you're an ex-con? Oh, you have so made my day. Thank you. Thank you for choosing my wedding chapel. You don't know how boring it can get here day after day. Now, I want details. I want to hear everything. Come, let's sit, have a chat. Please, right here. Yes, right here. Now, how did your two kids meet? And don't leave out a thing. Tell Aunt Sandy everything.
Well, okay, but you are going to marry us, right?
Of course. Let's just get to know each other a little bit first. I don't have another wedding for 45 minutes.
All right. Well, we met online. 3 years, 2 months, and 17 days ago.
Ain't it something how he counts the days?
I was lonely. My whole life, women were never interested in me or anything I was interested in, and I couldn't talk to them in person, so I started chatting online, and one night, I met Fiona.
Zippin' bitch from cell block 2.
And I was Marvelous Marvin.
Not at first, remember? At first you were Marvin Marvel, and I was like, dude, you're not supposed to use your real name.
And she suggested I be Marvelous Marvin.
Because he is so marvelous.
So, Marvin, what exactly was it that at first attracted you to Zip It Bitch?
Well, that's a funny story, ma'am. I thought she might be someone with a similar affection for the U.S. Postal Code. I thought Mike might be able to talk about the 9-digit zip code and the effects it's had on mail delivery.
Yeah, he didn't know it was my slammer name. I was always telling anybody that got in my face to Zip It Bitch. The name just kind of stuck.
Is that so? So even after you learned she was an inmate,
I was a convict, not an inmate.
Excuse me?
You see, ma'am, in prison vernacular, there is a big difference. Inmate is a derogatory term. Only guards and new arrivals who don't know the lingo yet say inmate. Everyone else says convict. It shows respect, see?
You are learning so much. This man could go into any prison anywhere in the country and speak the language beautifully.
Well, you're a good teacher.
No, you're a good teacher. What I have learned from this man about enjoying the little things in life and seeing the good in other people and forgiving yourself for not being perfect,
I didn't like myself very much before I met Marvin, but he saw things in me to like that no one else ever saw.
I can't imagine what. I mean, how about that?
Yes, once you get past all the fighting and the cursing and the criminal record and the powerful right cross, she's a very sweet girl.
So, can I ask, what were you in for?
Bank job. Yeah, I know. Fist talked me into driving the getaway car. It was my own stupid fault for going along. Naturally, his plan was stupid, and we got caught, and I got 15 to 25 years. Fist got even more because he was the mastermind. Mastermind! What a joke! Thank God he's out of my life forever. Anyway, at first, talking to Marvin just helped me pass the time, but I figured out pretty quick there was something special about this guy. Like, he knows so much stuff. And when it comes to postal regulations, forget about it.
Stop, Angela.
No, seriously, he knows, like, everything there is to know. Like, thousands of pages of stuff. You can ask him anything. Like, what size does a mail slot have to be?
Oh, the clear rectangle opening the outside slot plate must be at least 1.5 inches wide and 7 inches long, and the bottom of the slot must be at least 30 inches from the finished floor line.
Huh. What's the biggest thing you can mail?
Well, generally speaking, a no-mail piece may weigh more than 70 pounds, and except for a parcel post, no-mail piece may measure more than 108 inches in length and girth combined.
Can you mail an animal?
Some animals, yes, if they don't require food or water or attention during handling in the mail, and if they don't create any sanitary problems or obnoxious odors.
Really? Like what?
Oh, you know, certain types of foul and basic small cold-blooded animals.
Like baby alligators?
Yes, you remembered! And earthworms, salamanders, lizards, snails.
Snakes?
No snakes.
How about a turkey?
You can mail turkeys, doves, ducks, geese, swans.
How about a cat or a dog?
Nope, you can't mail any warm-blooded animals unless they're, except for a few specified birds.
How about bees?
Yes.
Insects?
Yep.
Live scorpions?
Sure can, but you must make sure you secure them a double mailing container. We don't want them breaking free.
See what I mean? You can't stop this guy, and I've been trying for 3 years.
And 2 months and 17 days.
You two are surprisingly sweet. I'm guessing since you're here, you must have been paroled early.
Yeah, I was. Again, thanks to Marvin. My first couple years in the joint, I was always getting in trouble, always fighting in the yard, but Marvin, he showed me that the smart thing to do is keep my mouth shut and play by the rules. So that's what I did. I did my shifts in the kitchen without complaining, kept to myself, and got paroled after 6.5 years for good behavior. Yesterday.
Yesterday?
Yes, ma'am. I drove down to the Tucson Federal Correctional Institute, picked her up in the afternoon, and we drove straight to Las Vegas last night, and here we are.
Oh my goodness, so is this the first time you two have actually met?
Oh, no, I visited her in jail many times over the years.
This sweet man would drive all the way from Wilbur, Nebraska to see me for 2 hours, then turn right back around and drive all the way home.
To Tucson? That's gotta be 1,000 miles.
Closer to 1,200.
You should have seen the day he proposed to me. Comes into the visitor's room, wear a tuxedo. He kneels down on one knee and he says to me, Fiona, would you make me the happiest man in the world and marry me? I was crying so hard I could hardly talk. Even Fat Ass, she was the head guard, called her Fat Ass for obvious reasons, even she was crying. So that's when we decided right then and there, the day I got paroled, we would drive right out to Las Vegas to get married. Everyone in the sale block got in on it, helped me pick the wedding chapel, make all the arrangements. Gave us all something happy to think about, you know?
That's beautiful. You're quite the romantic, aren't you?
Well, according to my mother, I'm quite the lunatic.
Your brother, too.
Yes, I wish they were here to help us celebrate, but they just don't understand. I told them you have to look past the exterior and see what's inside. That's why we're so happy. Fiona and I were able to do that, but they can't. When I showed my mother a picture of Fiona, she called her... I can't say it.
She called me a slut. And then I showed a picture of my mama to Marvin, Marvin to my mama, and she called me fruit.
She did?
Sorry, baby. It's just that you're so different than all the other guys I've been around. In a good way. See, I always went for losers that were going to get me in trouble and ruin my life. Kind of like fatal flaw, you know?
I hear you, sister. I've been married 4 times. Just got divorced for the 5th time, and already he's working his way back into my life. Biggest loser you ever want to meet. Drinks too much, works too little. In fact, He's supposed to be doing your ceremony, but he's passed out in the back room right now.
What?
But what can I say? He's got the bluest eyes you've ever seen.
Exactly. All my men have been the same. Big, tough, handsome men without a brain in their hands. But huh? The piercings, the tattoos, the muscles. Fist could lift me up over his head with one hand. He was an animal. They all were. They got him over that.
You know, Angel, I could lift you up over my head too if you wanted. I just didn't know you wanted that.
Huh?
Back when I was delivering the mail, I held the record for completing the 10-mile riverfront route in just 3 hours and 34 minutes while carrying a 50-pound satchel, thank you very much. And I'd be willing to take on any of your hot ex-boyfriends, even Fist if you wanted, and show them a thing or two.
What?
I've got loose, you know. You've just never seen me in action.
Margaret, what's going on? Are you jealous of Fist?
You know what I'd do is if he was here right now? First thing, get him in a headlock. Yep, I know how to do that. I was on the wrestling team. Okay? Never actually wrestled. I was a stopwatch guy, but I learned all the moves. So first thing, I get him in a headlock, then I'm spinning him around and around, take him down so fast he wouldn't know what hit him. Then I'd squeeze him in the vice that is my arm and make him apologize for all the lousy things he did to you or until he cried for his mommy. That's what I'd do. Mama!
Hey, kids. Happy to see me.
Fist, what the freak are you doing here?
Oh, I was in the neighborhood that I stopped by.
But you're still in jail.
Oh, yeah.
You get parole?
Madam speaking, I paroled myself.
You escaped?
Oh, I couldn't go on missing the wedding now, could I?
How'd you know about the wedding?
Oh, Fiona, there ain't no secrets in the joint. You should know that. I got boys in Tucson. They know me all about it. Said my girl was getting married to some other dude. They even knew which chapel. Naturally, I was not too happy.
I ain't your girl. I'd have to be a friggin' idiot to be your girl.
I guess you're still mad, huh? About the bank thing?
The bank thing? I got 15 years, Fist. You got 25.
All right. So I made a mistake. At least you got out early.
No thanks to you.
Me? What could I do? I've been sitting in jail with Hubcap. He says hi, by the way.
Hubcap, that moron. Even worse bank robber than you.
I'm sensing a lot of hostility here.
What do you think? You think I'd be glad to see him?
Yeah, I'm your guy.
You ain't my guy. He's my guy. And I want you to take your sorry ass out of here and leave us the frig alone.
After I come all this way, you're cold, Fiona. Cold, cold, cold. And what's with the frig? You stammering your mouth on you.
I'm trying to improve myself, something you wouldn't know nothing about.
Yeah, right about that. It's been a long time. You look older.
You look stupid.
You grew your hair.
You lost some of yours.
We ain't seen each other for 6 years. Ain't you got nothing nice to say to me?
You ruined my life!
I tell you, you do one wrong thing. This guy. It's kind of puny, ain't it? Yes.
Marvin.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, you.
Hey! You, chaplain, get back here. Sit down. I don't need you calling the cops on me.
I was just gonna...
Sit.
Yes, Mr. Fist.
So, I take it the wedding hasn't happened yet.
No, Mr. Fist.
Good. I would hate to miss the festivities.
What do you want, Fist? Why are you here?
Now that hurts my feelings. You don't want your oldest friend to be at your wedding? Fiona and me go way back. Should we tell you about us? We got a lot of history together.
Of course.
She ever tell you about the time that we were kids, like 10 or something. We stole an old man's car, drove down to Atlantic City. The cops pulled us over doing 90 down the Atlantic City Expressway, threw us in jail. Joel Man came and got us. Of course, he was hammered as always. Couldn't come for 2 days.
How come I always wound up in jail when I was with you?
Hey, we had some good times. Remember the time that we broke into the penthouse of the Waldorf Astoria and stayed for 3 nights, eating and drinking everything in the mini fridge? And doing it all night long. The only sensation of the upward.
You are a pig.
And you love it, baby. I see you still have my name on you, huh?
Yeah, and it's coming off as soon as I get home and find a doctor.
Yeah, and where's home, huh?
I live in Nebraska.
Nebraska? Holy shit, Fiona. What the frig are you gonna do in Nebraska? I don't even know. They have, like, roads in Nebraska?
We're gonna make a life.
We're gonna make a good life.
Doing what?
Well, just ordinary things. Going to work during the day. Having dinner at night. Working on our home and our garden. Fiona discovered horticulture in prison, and she really loves it, so hopefully she'll be able to find a job in that field.
Horticulture! He's gonna put you out on the streets! Not even I would have done that!
Not that kind of whore, you idiot! It's planting flowers and shit! I mean, stuff. Sorry.
You hear how she talks to me? This is how she'll be talking to you, my friend. Do you really think that Fiona is gonna be happy planting flowers in Nebraska? You don't know this girl like I do.
I know her.
Oh, yeah? What's her favorite color?
Red.
Wrong. Black. Ain't that right, baby?
I used to like black. Now I like colors. Red most of all.
What's her favorite magazine?
Magazine? Hell, she don't read.
Ladies, Home Journal. She read every page of every issue in prison. Where does she dream of going most in the world?
I know this. Disney World.
Yeah, when I was 9.
Paris, France, which is where we're going on our honeymoon. How many kids does she want to have?
All right, now this I know. After the growing up that we had, Fiona don't want no kids.
3. A boy, a girl, and a surprise.
All right, all right already. I ain't seen Fiona in 6 years, so naturally, some things have changed. But here's one thing that don't change. Postal boy. Where you come from? Fiona and me, we come from nothing. And nowhere. Her daddy used to beat the shit out of her. And her mama, except the only occasion that I came and stopped it. My mama, she walked the streets. We come from the same stinking place. We got ties, but they ain't never gonna be broken. At that right, Fiona?
Fisk, what do you want from me? Why are you here?
Because I can't let you marry this corn cob from Nebraska. You're marrying me. Yo, chapel lady.
Yes, Mr. Fisk.
Let's get this wedding going, huh? I got a lot of heat on me, so let's do it.
Okay, I'll go get the flowers and the reverend.
Well, make it quick.
Yeah, you loser. Mine, I'm marrying you.
Yeah, you are. You just got all confused in prison. You didn't have no men around you. And you met this guy. He was better than nothing, I guess. But Daddy's back. You don't have to go slumming no more.
I ain't slumming.
Do you even know this guy?
Of course I do.
Yeah? I found out some stuff.
Oh, yeah? How?
The computer. The internet.
Oh, how'd you do that? Seems how you can't read.
I got my boys to do it for me. What? Don't bust my balls. The thing is, Fiona, he's got a pass.
Oh, yeah?
Did you know that he is an Eagle Scout?
Yeah.
Did you know that he teaches Sunday school?
Yeah.
Did you know he volunteers at the library?
Yeah, so what's your point?
This guy is gonna bore the shit out of you. Fiona, he writes a column on why zip codes is important.
I never fully appreciated that till Marvin explained it to me.
He's a church-going do-gooder from Just Kill Me Already, Nebraska. You like danger, excitement, living on the edge, like me. Zippy here, he's gonna put you in a coma.
Okay, I must object.
Who the hell is he objecting to? We ain't in court.
I am not the insufferable bore you are making me out to be. I have done some very exciting things in my life, and I've seen danger.
Oh yeah? This I can't wait to hear. Lay it on me, mailbag.
You ever face down a 200-pound Doberman who slipped his leash and is planning on having you for lunch?
Yeah. Matter of fact, I have.
What'd you do?
Nothing. But they attacked me. Wasn't nothing I could do. Wasn't nothing nobody could do. He weighed 300 pounds.
That dog gets bigger every time you tell it. Seems nobody on our advance team bothered to figure out that the bank had a dog. I mean, Marvin, if you was gonna rob a bank, don't you think you would have found that out before going in?
Yes, I believe I would have. I like to do my homework.
All right. So I made a mistake. Kill me. What'd you do with your dog, big shot?
Well, as you know, the scout's motto is be prepared.
He don't know that.
Well, back when I was delivering mail, I made sure I was prepared for anything, especially dogs. This one time, I go into the Ramsey's yard, I see Damien there eyeing me up as usual, except this time, something's different. He's closer to me than usual, and then I realize he's not on the chain. And he's looking me over real good. He's looking me over, and he's seeing a tasty mailman sandwich!
Oh, Marvin, you're so funny.
What's so funny about that? That wasn't even a joke. I'll tell you a joke. Three hookers walk into a bar.
Shut up. So what happened with the dog, baby?
Well, you can see the gate is closed behind me. There's no way I'm making it over the fence.
So what'd you do then, baby?
Well, I assessed the situation quickly, and I realized it's not looking good. But I'm not worried, because I prepared for just this moment.
That's my Marvin.
So just before he lunges at me, I reach into my shirt, pull out my emergency postal whistle, and blow! I blow that thing with every breath in my body as birds scatter, cars veer off the road, low Damien sees stars. He runs whimpering under the porch until all I can see are his big, white, frightened eyes. I then deliver my mail to the front door, say hello to Mrs. Ramsey, remind her to tie Damien back up, and make my way out of the yard.
That's how you handle a big dog, moron.
Who the hell goes around wearing a whistle?
Than have a brain in his head. Damn you, Fish, that's 6 years of my life just thrown away. Thrown away and I ain't never gonna get it back. How could you be so stupid?
But how could you be so cold? Not answering a guy's letters in 6 years? I called. I had Hubcat write your letters and emails. And nothing. You didn't even have the courtesy of telling me to go to hell. That's how you felt.
All right, fine. Go to hell.
This is how it is.
This is how it is.
Well then, it's a good thing that I came by today now, isn't it? Goodbye, Fiona. If I never see your cold, cruel face again, it'll be too soon.
Goodbye? Don't let the door hit your sorry ass on the way out!
Oh, brother. All right, now we're gonna stop right where you are.
What the frick?
What are you doing, Marvin? Fiona, as much as I'd love to see him walk out of our lives forever, I can't let you end it this way.
Why not?
Yeah, why the hell not?
Because, Fist, she doesn't hate you, in spite of all the lousy things you've done over the years. In fact, she loves you. Yeah, until me, you were the only person who ever actually really cared about her. Even if it was in a highly unstable, often precarious way. And I could tell. Even when she told me the bad stories about you, she really missed you a lot. And Fiona, Fist didn't come here to berate you or to marry you. He came here to say that he's sorry for everything that has happened, that he misses you, and that he needs you as a friend. You two matter more to each other than you know, and it doesn't take a rocket scientist to see that. And Fist is right. You two have ties that can't be broken. And I may be crazy, but my conscience will not allow me to stand here and watch you two just throw it all away.
Okay, I've got the flowers, and after one more cup of coffee, I think our
You come here to apologize?
Yeah, I guess I did. I messed up, Fiona. I'm sorry about the bank job and the bad plan and you winding up in jail because of me. I wish I could change it, but I can't. I understand if you don't forgive me, but I wish you would, because I miss you, you know?
Did you come all the way to Las Vegas to tell me that?
Yeah.
You are such an idiot! Now you're never going to get parole! And who knows how many years they're going to add to your sentence! Oh, yes.
I've been in the joint for 6.5 years, Fiona. Give a man a break.
That is true.
So, you love Fiona enough, but you're willing to have me in your life?
Apparently so.
You're sure this is the guy that you want to marry? Even with him being so puny?
He's the biggest man I know.
All right, then. Got my blessing.
I must have missed something. Are we back to you two getting married?
Sure does. Is the minister, ready?
Let me check.
Oh, Margaret, we're finally getting married? And you're gonna stay and be our witness, right?
Yeah, I'll stay.
This is the Las Vegas police. The chaplain is surrounded. We know you're in there, Fisk. Come out now and no one gets hurt.
Marvin, what do we do?
Go on, back, out back!
No good, kids. They're in the alley, too.
Is there any other way out?
Just the front and the back, sorry.
Oh, Marvin, Fisk, you never had no luck at all, did you?
It's okay, I knew it would turn out this way. Hell, everybody in the joint knew where I was going. I only wish I could save it for you two's marriage.
Put down your weapons and come out, Fisk. No one has to get hurt here.
They think you're armed. That could buy us a few minutes. How fast can you marry us?
We've had a bit of a setback. I didn't know he was spiking the coffee I was giving him. I'm sorry.
It's just great. Of all the wedding chapels we could have picked.
No, thank God you picked mine. This has been fabulous.
What's the problem?
We don't have a minister, and unless you're a minister, this isn't going to happen.
Well, ain't this your lucky day, because I ain't.
Am what?
A minister. I took a course in the joint. Got my reverend credentials.
No way.
Yeah, it was Upcap's idea. Some scheme he was working on. Suddenly we needed a minister to make it work, so hell, I had the time.
Are you for real about this? You're really a...
Yep.
Well, all right then, kids, let's do this, bride. Right up here, groom, here, Reverend Fisk, right here. Let's go, let's go, let's go!
This day is not exactly working out the way I had planned.
Are you disappointed?
How could I be? I'm marrying you.
Okay, yeah, here we go. I hope I remember it all. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to join this woman, my beautiful Fiona, who I love so much. This guy wouldn't be my first choice, but Fiona seems to love him, so what are you going to do? Fiona, do you take this man to be your husband? Will you love him, honor and comfort him, forsaking all others, try to be a good wife to him? Don't bust his balls as much as you used to do me.
I will.
And you, do you take Fiona to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort, honor, keep her, forsaking all others, try to be a good husband and protect her from all the scumbags in the world and look out for her better than I did?
I will.
You've got 2 minutes, Fisk. Then we're coming in.
Go, 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 go!
Okay, now repeat your vows. I'm going to take you to
be
my husband
from
this day forward.
This day forward.
And better or worse,
better or worse.
Love and church,
love
as long as you both shall live.
Love and both shall live.
You have the rest of your life to kiss her. You take care, baby.
This is the police. Time's up. We're coming in.
I'm coming!
I'll write to you!
You better. Hey, Mom! Kiss the bride already.
Congratulations! Boy, you two are gonna have one great wedding story to tell your kids, huh?
Anybody else wants to listen?
Well, all that's left to do I wish you kids good luck, but you don't need it.
Why not?
Because I can tell you've got the real thing.
I bet working at a wedding chapel, you see it all the time, huh?
Hardly ever, Marvin.
Oh, thank you, Sandy. We're gonna miss you so much.
Oh,
thanks, Sandy. Bye.
Hey, Sandy!
Oh. Have a good life, kids. Okay, got the champagne on ice. Caterers are setting up. I'm all dressed. Place looks great. Sweetie, how are you doing back there? Do you need help with your tie?
No.
Okay. I can't believe I'm doing this again. We must be out of our minds. But the real question is, where are all of our guests?
Hey, Sandy. Ugh. Sorry we're late.
I was just starting to get worried.
Well, we should have been here a half an hour ago.
Sandy, it looks beautiful.
So do you. I love this. Where did you get it?
A little shop out near Fremont Street. They have great vintage clothes and jewelry. We should go sometime.
I'd love to. I hear you're becoming quite the Las Vegan. John tells me you know the city better than he does now.
No.
And that you've learned the chapel business like a pro. What do you think of it?
It's interesting, that's for sure.
It gets even more interesting as you go. So, can you believe I'm doing this again?
You always said fifth time was gonna be the charm.
I know, but still, you two must think I'm crazy.
We think you're great. Heck, if it weren't for you, we wouldn't have met, fallen in love, and I wouldn't have proposed to her.
Ah, I knew it. I knew it was going to happen. Congratulations. I insist on marrying you in my chapel.
Well, she hasn't answered me yet.
Well,
I mean, after a week, don't you think a guy deserves an answer?
I really don't know. Why don't we have some champagne? I know we should probably wait until after the ceremony, but what the hell, huh?
Yes, please.
Well, it's just that if you love someone, you wouldn't think it'd be that hard of a question. You know what I mean?
You are really embarrassing me.
Well, it is the only way I can get you to talk to me. Ugh. It's the only way I can get her to talk to me.
Let's drink. To Sandy, always a bride, never a bridesmaid, and to my wedding, the fifth one, long may it wave.
Oh, yeah, it's just like I remembered it. There's where we told Sandy our whole story, and there's where Fist nearly broke your hand. And that's where we were married as the police surrounded the building.
Great memories, huh?
Yeah. Was that a cops and robbers wedding theme?
No, that was real life. Marvin and Fiona are one of my all-time greatest weddings. So, are you happy? Yeah, you're happy. You ever hear from Fist?
Yeah, we hear from Fist.
Well, how's he doing?
He's doing great. Marvin got him a good lawyer, and guess what happened?
What?
They found out that the cops at the bank never read his rights, so they let him go. Can you believe it? So he came to live with us, you know, for a while, just until he gets back up on his feet. What was that, 3 weeks ago?
3 months, 12 days, and 17 hours.
And guess what else?
What?
He's here now. He came with us.
He's here?
Yes, of course he's here. He's always here.
He's just parking the car.
Hey, chapel lady! Congratulations! How about a hug for
Fist, that's great. I think it's time you start calling me
things sure have changed since the last time we was here. I'm a free man.
Yes, I heard.
And I'm a better man. You know how I'll come? Because of this guy right here. I know he don't look like much, but how many guys you know will let their wife's ex-boyfriend move in with him and get him out of jail, huh? And he's changed my life forever. Hasn't he, Fiona? Ain't I the best that I've ever been since I moved in with you?
You sure are. He changed you just like he changed me.
So you're just one big happy family, huh?
Yes, we are family. That's something I never had before.
Oh, Fizz.
Okay, one big happy family.
Marvin, are you all right?
Oh, of course. I'm terrific. How about some champagne? Can I pour you a glass, Angel?
Let me get that, Mom.
No! She is my wife, and I can pour her a glass of champagne.
Whoa! Marv! You seem a little on edge today.
Yeah, you do, baby.
Anybody else think that Mom seem on edge? Say it. Don't Mom seem on edge?
Of course he's on edge. Been living in his house for 3 months.
And 12 days and 17 hours!
I'm surprised the man's not on the ledge. The guy wants his privacy and his wife back. It's not that hard to figure out.
And who are you?
One very agitated man today. I would not mess with me.
Oh, tough guy, huh?
Yeah, you want a piece of this, what is it, hand or finger?
It's fist. And I'll be glad to introduce you to it.
Great. Jack, what are you doing?
I'm sorry, Sandy. I'm a little stressed right now.
And you? I thought you said you had changed.
I did. Didn't you see my restraint? The old fist would have
killed me!
All right! Let's just everybody calm down.
We are now entering Sandy's Chapel of Love. This is take one. And action.
What the hell? Welcome, friends. Today, we're making plans for my upcoming wedding. Aren't weddings the most wonderful events, Bryce?
They sure are, Vanessa.
We've chosen a little chapel here in Las Vegas that specializes in celebrity weddings. Let's meet the proprietor.
What are you two doing here again?
Again? No, you must be mistaken. This is our first time here. Vanessa Wells.
And Bryce Cannon.
Yes, I'm aware of who you are.
Well, of course you do. The
whole world knows who we are.
What you may not know is that Bryce and I are now the stars of our own hit reality show, a weekly docudrama chronicling the daily happenings and fascinating moments of our extraordinary lives. Today, we are making plans for my upcoming wedding to the Turkish ambassador, Ahmet Rushdiegistan. Now, chapel proprietor, I want you to take us through all our options and show our viewers what a first-class wedding looks like. I want this event to be fabulous. Shall we sit?
No, we shall not sit. You can't just barge in here and take over the place. There's a wedding going on, for God's sake.
Ooh. Oh, one of these little people here.
If you must know, it's me. I'm getting married. So just take your cameras out of here, and if you want to schedule filming for another time, perhaps we can arrange something.
Ooh. I'm sorry, that won't do. We're on a deadline, you see.
Yeah, we have a deadline.
We need a completed segment by tonight. So, why don't you just go ahead and finish your little ceremony, and we'll just have a seat until you're done.
I believe the lady asked you to leave.
Yeah, I heard her too.
So you gotta leave on your own, or do we got
to? Guys! It's okay, let them stay. Fine, whatever. You can film the wedding, but you'll film my wedding for free, right?
Yes.
Okay, well, let's get started then. Everyone take a seat and we'll get this thing going. Well, we've gotten off to a bit of a rocky start, but maybe that's a good omen. I don't know. Anyway, thank you all for coming to my wedding. When you get to the fifth one, it gets a little embarrassing, but I'm hoping and believing that this time is going to be the last time. Marvin and Fiona, I asked you to come because you are by far the happiest couple I've ever married. You're an inspiration to couples everywhere. Maybe not at this particular moment, since you seem to be having some issues, but normally speaking.
Oh, we're not having issues. Fiona and I couldn't be happier. She's an angel. We're having issues!
We are?
Yes!
I didn't know that.
That's why I'm telling you!
Is it what that guy was saying about you wanting your privacy back?
Yes!
Oh, jeez. I couldn't even tell. That's what's so amazing about this guy.
You should be filming this guy right here.
Even when he is pissed off, he's still a nice guy. I got so much to learn from him.
Yeah? Well, you're gonna be doing it from your own apartment. You're moving out, Fisk! Out! If I have to throw you out, I will. So, Fiona's mine, okay? She's my wife!
Marvin, you're being so forceful.
All right, I'll move out.
You will?
Sure, whatever you want. I used to come over, though, and help sort the mail and work on my reading and be part of the family.
Yes, of course. Once a week.
I think I need at least twice a week if I'm ever going to be as good as you.
Okay, twice a week. Then it says. Okay, Fiona?
You're really something when you're angry, ain't you?
Well.
I like it. Just wait till we get back to Wilbur.
Where the hell is Wilbur?
It's in Nebraska. That's where they live.
Nebraska? Dear God, you poor child. Why in the world would you drag her off to such a place? You got a problem with Nebraska?
Uh-oh, now you done it.
I don't even know where it is, to tell you the truth. You and your Ken doll boyfriend and your fancy camera crew and your fancy clothes.
He's not my boyfriend. He's as gay as a mountain breeze.
I don't like you disrespecting my husband in my home, bitch.
Did you hear what she just called me?
Now you either say you're sorry or I'm gonna have to jack you up the way I jacked up that snitch bitch in the big ass. And it wasn't pretty.
What is she saying? I don't understand any of these words.
I think she intends to harm you.
Well, just protect me,
Jack. You up his
stand up for him.
Oh, Marvin.
Okay! Meanwhile, back at Sandy's wedding.
Sorry, Sandy.
Sorry.
John and Beth, I invited you because, John, well, you're one of my best friends. You've been there for me for so many years, looked out for me time and time again. I love you. And Bev, you have made John so happy. Up until today, then, is, or maybe up until last week?
What happened last week?
Oh my God, would you shut up? These people are obviously unstable.
I asked her to marry me, and it was really romantic, too. Dinner at the Bellagio, best hotel in the city, best table in the room. I even had violinists come over and play. And over flaming baked Alaska, I got out my grandmother's ring. I got down on my knee, and I asked her to be my wife. And she said, "Can I think about it?"
Ouch, damn. Shit, thank you.
Don't look at me that way, everybody. You don't understand. Of course I want to marry John. Nothing would make me happier than to be your wife.
You're saying you do want to marry me?
The question is, do you want to marry me?
Well, I asked you, didn't I?
I need for you to be sure, really sure, because I got left at this altar once and I can't go through that again. Not with you.
Is that what this is all about? Listen,
I have waited a long time to find the right woman. And I found her. And it's you. And I'm really, 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 really sure.
In that case, yes.
It's official!
Congratulations, you two. I just love it when things work out. Oh, how's my makeup? Is it still okay?
You're fine.
What were we doing? Oh, right! Sandy's getting married! Where's my groom? Where's my minister? Hey, you guys, come on. I'm not getting any younger out here.
Oh, my God, it's that horrible little man. Don't tell me he's the minister.
Of course not. He's the groom. Hi, sweetie. You look wonderful.
No, you look wonderful. Hey, everyone, can you believe how lucky I am? Look at my beautiful bride. Oh, look who it is. It's...
Vanessa Wells.
And Bryce Cannon.
Right. Hey, thanks for coming. These two have been down on their luck for a long time. She's a lush and he, takes a swing from the other side of the plate, if you know what I mean.
We can't hear you.
Hey, how about we get this show on the road?
I got a honeymoon to get started.
Well, all we need now is this minister. Ken, are you ready? John, can you... He promised me he'd be okay to do this today, and believe it or not, we all became good friends. Me, Lou, Ken, it just seems so natural to ask him. Well?
Ken's sick. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Feel like performing a wedding?
I'd be honored to. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to deny...
Wait.
What's wrong? You're not changing your mind, are you?
No, I just thought, what the hell? As long as John's doing the ceremony, why don't we get married by Elvis?
I don't have my costume.
That's okay. What do you think, Lou?
I love it. Marry us, Elvis.
Well, I've never been one to turn down a gig as looking.
Live from Las Vegas, it's showtime. Tonight, we're going to celebrate the wedding of these two very special kids, Stan and Lou. We're going to celebrate your special day and your special union. Elvis style. Wise men say, only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love
with you. Thank you very much.